Taja Davis, and for the next 30 minutes, we'll take a journey through the people and stories that make up UCSB Athletics. This is Gauchos In 30. As this season of Gauchos In 30 comes to a close, we'll take a look at the end of the year's baseball and softball seasons with Gaucho Vision recaps of their last home series.
I would say yesterday played great defense. I mean, best defensive effort from the entire team that I've ever been a part of in my career. Our starting pitchers Friday and Saturday gave us a chance to win both days. Every weekend in the Big West is difficult. There's no free passes. There's nobody to beat up on. You have to bring your A game every single day, and we didn't do that today. And the scoreboard showed that. This is too good of a conference. I think it's the fifth best conference or something in the nation. And every team's got the ability to beat you in different ways. They're a scrappy team, and you know, today they scrapped and they out-scrapped us, and we didn't play to our ability, and the scoreboard showed that. So I would say that's just a testament to our conference and shows that you got to bring it every day.
We came out the first 2 days. We struggled a little bit on Friday, and we pulled out a win. And yesterday I thought we came together really well as a team, and we played good team defense and had good hits when we needed them. We had clutch hits. They have a scrappy team. They've struggled a little bit in the past, I know, but they have a scrappy team who wants to win, and they want to beat you every day. So I think more so than what they did, I think we kind of beat ourselves today, and we didn't come through in clutch situations.
It's emotional. You know, these are my best friends. Life's going to be full of ups and downs, and I don't know where it's going to take me. I don't know where it's going to take them, but the memories I've made with these guys, the friendships, the relationships I have with these people, I'll never have with anybody ever again. And I feel truly blessed to have gotten to be out here and blood, sweat, tears, smiles with all these guys. And Cuneo, Israel, Morrow, those guys, I'm seniors, you know, we're all seniors. And you know, those are my best friends. And the entire group, you know, I'm never going to get to play with another group like this again. And I am truly blessed and truly thankful that I've gotten to spend this much time with these guys. And wish them the best of luck down the road.
I mean, guys like this, you can't say enough about Joey. I know he gets a lot of praise, but that's because he deserves it. I mean, he comes out every day and he gives everything he can. I know that he would lay it down for me in any situation, on and off the field. He would do anything for us. So, I mean, I love playing with this guy as a person and as a teammate.
This team is more heart and more love for each other than any team in the Big West. And we're leaving this field knowing that we had an incredible year and a lot of fight, and we had a lot of fun. And I'm proud of each and every one of my teammates. And regardless of how it ended, this was a really good weekend. You know, we came out swinging, we put up 6 runs, and we were loud, and we were having fun, and you know, and then they came up, and we were down by 3, and we fought.
This team never gave up. Even to the end, we were still down. You know, we were down by more than one or a few in a couple games, and they punched right back. You know, that's just been the hallmark of this team throughout the entire season, is that can't ever count us out. You know, batters 1 through 9, players 1 through 19. They played together this weekend, and that's what we wanted from them, that's what we asked of them, and that's what they delivered. I think just, you know, generally putting the ball in play and taking advantage of any kind of misplayed balls. Players did a good job of swinging at some better pitches and working at bats. So when we did have success, it was working ABs and, again, kind of working with each other and stringing hits together. Yeah, I mean, from the start, we've talked about 2014 being a really special year, and a lot of that has to do with who the leaders of your team are, and it starts with the senior class and just the chemistry and how they've worked together on and off the field. And you know, it's been a really special year, and it would have been amazing to be able to cap it off with the first ever conference title. But I mean, even that, this is the best kind of winning percentage that this program's ever had. You know, being able to tie the most wins in a season, there are definitely things that this group have to be proud of throughout this entire year. And you know, I'm proud of how they've, it's just in, you know, the whole process of them getting here and being able to see them grow up, and then now sending them out as leaders is one of the most successful years in the program. It's exciting for them, and it's been an honor to be able to coach them.
The Golden Eagle Award highlights the strongest player academically with the highest GPA of each of the Gaucho sports during the year. Let's take a look at a recap of the award ceremony.
I think everyone here is really hardworking and, you know, both in their sport and in the classroom, and it's just great to come together and kind of have family here and really just kind of celebrate it, I guess. Oh, just congratulations. It doesn't always, I guess there's a lot of work that goes into it that maybe not everybody realizes, you know, just kind of the behind the scenes stuff that really this is where it pays off, I guess. And it kind of, yeah, it's nice to be recognized for it.
A lot of time is spent recognizing achievements on the court and on the field, and it's really nice to be appreciated for what athletes can do outside of the classroom. And it's also nice to have everybody here that's helped us with that, because it's not just like one person that can do it. It's a support of a bunch of people.
It's hard, but it's rewarding. I think we kind of have to be very responsible with our time. Sometimes it feels like you're going from thing to thing, but you know, you really just have to stay on top of things, and I think just make sacrifices in areas that you really love. So if you know, it's hard work, but we love it, and in the end, it always pays off. So.
Hi, my name is Anne. I'm on the swim and dive team, and I swim fly, and I am. I'm studying biochemistry. I was really interested in chemistry in high school. I liked it a lot, and I knew I wanted to go into the medical field, so I thought biochem would be a good place for that. Last year I won the Golden Eagle Award for the women's swim team, and that was just a really great event to be a part of. I felt very honored to be there, and I met a lot of great people. It's always really hard balancing school and swim practices, but I've learned a lot of time management throughout the years. So from some practice in the morning, classes all day, some practice in the afternoon, and you know, not able to do any schoolwork till late at night. And I've been able to carry that with me through my college years. And the coaches have been really supportive of when I've had labs that extend really long periods of time. I've had to make up workouts and swim at different times. Sometime in the off season after my freshman year, I developed a lot of back pain. Not exactly sure what the cause was. Saw a lot of doctors, a lot of physical therapists. I couldn't narrow it down to one specific problem. It's likely just caused by the scoliosis and balance in my back. For the next 3 years of my swimming career, I had to kind of push through the pain and find ways to get workouts in, like substituting for weights. I wasn't able to lift weights for 2 years. I had to do spin classes and find my own ways to work out. I'd probably have to keep swimming, actually, for the rest of my life, because it's one of the best things for it, even though it hurt me along the way. It also is the only thing that'll keep it stable and keep it strong. My teammates have been really supportive throughout injuries, throughout, you know, tough times with school. My coaches as well, they've always had a lot of confidence in me. I take a lot of pride in being a Gaucho. I've not regretted 1 minute of being an athlete for 4 years or picking the hard major that I chose.
Hi, I'm Taran Brown. I'm a shooting guard for UCSB men's basketball. I'm from Gillette, Wyoming, a long ways away from here. Small town, about 40,000 people. I grew up there my whole life. It's a lot different out there. I mean, I would say there's a lot more humble people out there, a lot more down-to-earth people out there, but I mean, it has a lot of diversity and stuff too. One thing I really miss back home in Wyoming, I did a lot of fishing, a lot of camping and things in the outdoors. I started basketball, I mean, before I was five. I got on a traveling team at a young age. We weren't fortunate enough to have AAU teams out in Wyoming because the population is too low. So I just got to be on like a traveling team with my friends, and we would travel around to different states around Wyoming, South Dakota, that area, and just to kind of get our names out that way. My dream was always to play Division I basketball, but it was just so hard coming from a place like that. So I mean, I was just in the gym day by day at the rec center, just 7 in the morning, 9 o'clock at night, you know, just all the way through. Just I'd go grab some lunch and come back and just put in more work. I was the only Division I player to come out of my high school. There's not a lot of coaches that look at small schools like that, so that was very tough for me. I always idolized Kevin Durant. That's why I'm number 35. I picked that my ninth grade year. The only other player to come out of Wyoming to make it to Division I and to the NBA was James Johnson, and I'm looking to be the next. He went to play Wake Forest and then went to play in Toronto. My parents mean the world to me. I wouldn't be here where I am right now, even in the second right now, without them. I mean, they sent me to multiple basketball tournaments all over the country to get my name out there and supported me the whole way. It was a kind of a cool thing. Coach Williams came out to my house and did an in-home visit for me before I committed here at UCSB, and we brought him out to the coal mine where my dad works and showed him around. It was a whole new experience for him, so it was kind of cool. And just there having him in my house and just showing that he really cares meant a lot to me. And that showed a huge impact on my choice and why I came here. Going to school here, we get to travel to many different places, and Coach promised me when I signed here that we could do a trip out to Wyoming. And we did that trip last year, and it was just a phenomenal trip. I mean, I had so much support from all the state there and all my family. I mean, the place was just a sold out place, and it was just great vibes and a good feeling to know that I still have that support, even though I'm still so far away from home and I have all these people that still care for me. Being on this team here at UCSB has been a very good thing for me, just for the fact that we have so much support throughout the players. We all connect very well. Our coaches are always there for us anytime we need any help with anything. I have wonderful living scholar parents, Brian Escalera and Jan Escalera, and they're there just in a second if I need anything from them. And just being so far away from home, it's nice to have that second family here. It's just really nice to know that I have someone around when I need a helping hand.
The people that make up the UCSB women's basketball program are the epitome of Gauchos Go Far. Let's check out what some alumni players had to say about women's basketball coach Mitch and about the program.
UCSB was really an integral, irreplaceable stepping stone for me in getting me to where I am today and positioning me for the future. And playing for Coach Mitch, there was never a dull moment, and every day was hard work. She liked to say that there was a method behind the madness, and I agree with every one of those words in that statement.
The one thing that is really special and unique about the women's basketball program at UCSB is that Coach Mitch's care and love for her players, it goes way beyond the basketball court. She not only cares about the basketball aspect of things, but she cares about grooming her players into strong, responsible young women.
She made sure that we had to work for everything, because that meant it meant so much more when we achieved things. And it also placed us in a position to really succeed outside the court and outside the classroom.
Two things that you can always expect from Coach Mitch is, one, she will push you to be the best basketball player that you are capable of being, and two, she will push you to your limit mentally, just giving you that constant reminder that in life, nothing's given to you. You have to constantly work for everything. And I think every player that's gone through her program, that's something that has stuck with them. Personally, it's something that's stuck with me.
It's incredible to see how much support there is for the program, and I can't encourage it more, because when you invest in that program, you're investing in the future of not only all those young women on the team, but of this earth. You invest in the youth and you invest in the future, and I can't think of any better way to do so than to invest in the program and Coach Mitch and her staff and her students and her athletes, and keep what's going in that program going strong and just getting better every year.
Investing in the women's basketball program not only contributes to wins and successes on the court, but it helps produce young, passionate, strong Gaucho women who are more than capable of going out in the real world and doing great things.
For years, the University of California has been able to provide Californians with an affordable, world-class education.
Last year, UC gave out more grants and scholarships than ever before.
But even with that financial help,
most students still need loans,
part-time jobs, or both to pay for their education. Let's make a promise to change that.
It begins now with the Promise for Education, a new kind of crowdfunding platform.
Here's how it works. You make a promise.
I got a promise.
Bungee jump!
I kind of have two that I've been throwing around.
I will work at a soup kitchen for 2,000 hours.
I'm a rep as President Obama, if there's any indication.
After you made a promise, set a goal.
It can be $10.
It could be $100, $1,000,
$1,000,000.
And you share it on Facebook or
Twitter.
Or what I use, Pimpstagram.
You share it with your mom or your dad or your friends, and you rally your friends.
And their friends and their friends' friends.
To contribute money towards your goal.
And remember, every little bit makes a difference.
At the end of the program, all the contributions made will be used to create
more UC scholarships. That's good news.
We need everyone to participate. Students,
Californians, Americans,
alumni, teachers, anyone who cares about education to make this a success.
Help change the future by supporting scholarships for students in need.
A lot of students like myself.
Like us, first generation.
Start by making a promise.
Make a promise for education.
What will you promise?
Hi, I'm Fifi Biaden, a senior midfielder for UCSB men's soccer. This summer, I went back home to Ghana. It's been like 5 years since I went back home, and I really wanted to do something back home, like to give back to my country and to help the kids that are underprivileged as I was growing up as well. So I went back home to work at this orphanage called Orphan Aid Africa, and I was there for 3.5 weeks. And mainly what I did was I coached the kids, and also I taught them about, you know, life lessons, about what it means to work hard, what it means to be disciplined, and what it means to value education as you're growing up. And it was a great experience. Growing up, it was tough. I was in the same position as the kids back home. I couldn't get the same education that I needed. I couldn't get the same opportunities that I have now. So I felt like it's a responsibility of mine to try and change that situation for the kids back home. I bought some kits from UCSB store, really cool soccer gear, and the kids were really, really happy to receive them. So I organized like a soccer tournament and also a basketball tournament for the girls, and it was really fun, and they really enjoyed it. And I gave out the gear, you know, for best players and those who showed more like team players instead of themselves, and those who were working hard and everything. And I also congratulated them for their efforts. It's one of my passions to give back, not just to my country, but any community or any country that's, you know, have underprivileged children. It's important to have that realization that it's not everyone that's in the same situation as we are or as someone else's. And it doesn't matter whether you are rich or where you come from, you can always make a difference in some other people's life. And one of the greatest things that I learned through my experience back home is putting a smile on someone's face. I've been planning this in my head to go back to my country to do something different. UCSB granted me the opportunity and helped me to learn what it means to give back. Lastly, well, I just want to say that this video is just, you know, a first step or just a preview of what it means for everyone to be humans on this earth. Wherever you are or whoever you are, you can always do something different. You can also always make a difference, inspire others and put a smile on other people's faces. And I think that's the greatest gift that a person can ever have.
The next season of Gauchos In 30 will open with the new seasons of the UCSB soccer teams in full motion, where the Gauchos play their hearts out and call their home is Harder Stadium, also known as Soccer Heaven. We'll be right back.
quite obvious that soccer heaven is here.
You definitely have the fans, the weather, everything, the field's nice, everything, that all the work that everyone puts into this place, it is soccer heaven.
We have the best fans in America, and they show up to every game committed, throwing tortillas after every goal. Just playing here has just been a real, real experience for me. It's like playing in a pro culture. I mean, you don't get this many fans in MLS sometimes.
Kind of came around as a marketing term of which everything else could come under, and we were trying to find something that was as big as what's happening here in Santa Barbara. Our athletic department does a great job of marketing, and next thing you know, we had soccer heaven everywhere. It has a bigger feel to it than, maybe Soccer Town. And obviously, heaven, soccer heaven, the perfect place to be, the perfect place to play soccer. Is there anywhere else like it in the country? And there isn't.
For the nation to see that, I thought that was a big deal for our school, for Santa Barbara itself.
It was tremendous. I had not been here for a game, but I'd heard a lot about it. It was everything it was cracked up to be, and I think it made for a great atmosphere, and that's what you want. Playing in the national championship, you want an atmosphere, and you want good weather, you want a good field, and we had that. And I think that allowed us to play our game, and in the end, I think the best team won. Looking forward to enjoying the rest of the day on the beach.
We've been involved with the Special Olympics now for 5 years. It started over at the Muni courts, and more recently we've been able to move here to the Tennis Club of Santa Barbara, so a really nice venue. I know we get a lot out of it. Our players probably get more out of the event than the Special Olympians do. We feed off their enthusiasm for the sport, and I think our guys come back with renewed passion for tennis when they get done with this event.
This is my third year doing the Special Olympics event here at Santa Barbara Tennis Club, and it's an absolute blast every time. It's a great way to give back to the community and to really stay involved.
We're proud to be with these guys. They've been through a lot, and we, through Gauchos Give, we're able to come back to the community and give our efforts and our thoughts and our love to them.
It's really fun. It's a great way to meet the new members of our team and have a good bonding time with them. And you just get a sense of personal fulfillment. You help out a lot of nice guys, the Special Olympians.
Well, Gaucho Gives is a great program. It's important for all our student athletes to understand how important it is to be a good member of this community. We get an awful lot of support from the tennis community. It helps us be successful, and it gives our student athletes a really quality experience at UCSB. So getting involved in stuff like this is a must for us, and we really enjoy it. That's the thing. It's really fun to get involved, especially with Special Olympians who have so much enthusiasm for the game. So it's a win-win all the way around.
We enjoy every moment with these guys. They you see the smiles on their faces, and it means a lot to us. We'll come back every year and do it all over again.
Today we're honoring our student athletes who earned above a 3.5 GPA last quarter. They also have to have a 3.0 cumulative GPA, so it's a very special group of students that we have.
Students are always really excited. We send out an invitation via email, and the RSVPs start coming back instantly all the way through the deadline. And I even get students afterwards who say, I'm so sorry, I forgot, but you know, is there a way I can attend? And as always, the answer is yes. We love to have a full room. We love to have a space that is filled with energy and the students who are doing well so that they can encourage their teammates to then join us next quarter. Being a student athlete is hard, no matter what sport team you're on. If you're in season or out of season, there's different challenges that come along with it. So for the students that are here today, we just want to celebrate them and say congratulations. It's the least we can do because they give a lot of effort and it takes a lot of energy to do what they do on a daily basis.
Looking for the best in Gaucho gear? Look no further than shopucsbgauchos.com. UCSB Athletics is pleased to announce the debut of our new online store, shopucsbgauchos.com. Gaucho fans can now find thousands of items to choose from. It is the biggest assortment of Gaucho gear ever assembled under one roof. With a full line of women's and youth apparel, performance gear, sweatshirts, tees, and headwear, shopucsbgauchos.com has something for everybody. Grab yourself or someone you love something new from the Gaucho shop at shopucsbgauchos.com today.
For UCSB Athletics, I'm Taja Davis, and that's all for this season of Gauchos in 30. For all of your Gaucho gear needs, don't forget to visit shopucsbgauchos.com. And lastly, for more videos like these and for a way to buy tickets online, please visit ucsbgauchos.com. See you next season.